with the top five men and the top five women from Kona. It's pretty cool. I'll take you along. You'll see what Winnipeg is like in the winter.
You know, you all might not think it, being from not frozen parts of the world.
What's up, Trainiacs? This is out, so you know what that means if you've been around for longer than about 5 days. It means that there's some cool stuff happening out on the interwebs in the world of triathlon, and we're going to dissect it right here. Now, what came out just recently is the 2017 Ironman World Championship Interactive Quark Collector Pacing Analysis. You see that? Basically, what this guy Ryan Cooper from TrainingPeaks did was he took a bunch of time data from, I believe, all of the pros in Kona. He created these fancy schmancy graphs that we can see kind of how the race unfolds with the top five men and the top five women from Kona. It's pretty cool. Now, I haven't read his analysis of it because I want to go in fresh. I don't want to be tainted. I'm pure, folks. This is nothing but Taren goods. Hang on, my drywall guy. Hey, Grant.
If it works for you, if I could get you to get your guys to do the ceiling.
Little bit of work for Triathlon Taren HQ that I gotta do. Get it ready for drywall guy, drywall Grant. You gotta have a drywall guy. Anyway, let's look at how the race played out. Shall we, Gracie? Right? Okay, so what we've got here is Daniela Ryf in blue, Lucy Charles in green, Sarah Crowley in red, Heather Jackson in teal, and Kesa Sally in purple. Along the left is the time gap, and then along the right is the altitude. The dotted line, that is the end of the bike. Along the bottom is the time from the beginning of the bike. The swim isn't included in this. So the one thing that we can see here in the blue and the red to illustrate how this works is that Sarah Crowley said she came out into the bike basically right with Daniela Ryf and wanted to hang on her wheel and not lose sight of her no matter how hard Daniela Ryf went. And you see that throughout the course of the bike, Sarah Crowley was basically just right in behind, just a slight gap. Then here, about 40K from the finish of the bike is when, boom, Daniela Ryf took off and she decided that she was gonna try to overtake Lucy Charles and get in front of her coming into T2. You can also see that Sarah Crowley tried to stay with her. She tried. Good effort, Sarah. Next week, we have a podcast lined up with Sarah Crowley. Stay subscribed to this or check us out, Triathlon Taren Podcast, and make sure you subscribe to make sure you don't miss that. Oh, and go and subscribe to Sarah Crowley's YouTube channel. She's got a YouTube channel and she wants me to help her get over 100 subscribers. I think we can do that, Trainiacs. Make sure you go comment on one of her videos and say Triathlon Taren sent you. Let's hook her up. She seems so nice. So she tried to hang on, but Daniela Ryf in the end showed her bike prowess and Sarah Crowley pittered out, and there was a gap created. You also see that Lucy Charles actually gained a fair bit of time on Daniela Ryf in the first, say, 40-50K of the bike, then basically just held it, and then once Daniela Ryf, boom, turned on the afterburners, the gap between the two, this isn't their speed, this is the time gap, remember, the gap between the two started narrowing up, so that by the time they got into T2, Daniela Ryf had a few minutes on Lucy Charles. Heather Jackson actually had a really good bike. She just slowly gained time throughout. And then after about 50K or so, it looked like she turned on the juice, pushed some serious power until there was about 40K left. And then she came really, really close to being right with Daniela Ryf, but boom, pittered out. Couldn't keep pace with that hard last final 40K time trial that Daniela Ryf talked about. Kesa Sally, who's known more for her running than her biking, same sort of thing. She tried and tried to hold on until about the halfway point. This peak here is the halfway point at Javi. She wasn't able to keep pace, and that's when she started backing off and lost quite a bit of time. After this point here, we get into the run. Daniela Ryf had the fastest run of the day, and she just gained time over and over and over, mile after mile, while even though Lucy Charles still had a good run, she just consistently lost time, as did Sarah Crowley, as did Heather Jackson. We see that Sarah Crowley and Heather Jackson down here, they had a little battle, and on the Queen K Highway coming back was when Heather Jackson and Sarah Crowley were battling it out side by side. You can see they were like neck and neck almost through the entire run. And then in the last few miles, Sarah Crowley pulled away. Kesa Sally, as I mentioned, is known more for her running, and she just gained slight bits of time, basically keeping pace with Daniela Ryf from the looks of it for two thirds of the run, but Daniela Ryf just consistently knocked off those miles, and Kesa Sally even couldn't keep up. In the men's race, we've got some really big swings here. We got Patrick Lange, we got Lionel Sanders, we got David McNamee, we got Sebastian Keinle, we got James Kunama. You can see that the super bikers, Lionel Sanders and Sebastian Keinle, started at the same time, while the better swimmers, but people that are known more for their run, Patrick Lange, David McNamee, and James Kunama, they all came out of the water basically together, biked together, because Lionel Sanders and Sebastian Keinle worked together to keep up to them. Just before Javi, the super bikers obviously took over the non-bikers and consistently gained time. Now James Kunama, you can see that he let Sebastian Keinle and Lionel Sanders pass him for a few miles, and then he tried to work hard, get back up to them, didn't quite do it, and hung on within about sniffing distance for a few miles, but eventually tailed off. Meanwhile, David McNamee and Patrick Lange, who aren't nearly as good a cyclist as Keinle and Sanders and Cameron Wirth, who hammered it, they just consistently lost time all the way up into T2. And look at this huge gap between Patrick Lange and Lionel Sanders and Sebastian Keinle. Like 10 minutes when I was in T2 getting footage, Patrick Lange came by and I got footage of him, and I was like, might as well just get some junk footage of Lange. He's so far back, he's not even gonna be a factor. Well, was I wrong? Because look at this, boom, all the way through. For the first few miles, David McNamee and Patrick Lange ran together, and then at about a third of the way through the marathon, like 8 miles in, as they were coming out of town, I actually saw this. I was right there. I saw Patrick Lange go up Palani Road out into the Queen K Highway, and bam, he hammered it. And look at this pace that he started gaining. First he passes James Kunama, then he passes Sebastian Keinle. Then with about 3 miles left, he passed Lionel Sanders, and still, boom, gained a huge amount of time. James Kunama lost time throughout the entire run, not being known for his run. David McNamee gained a fair bit of time. Sebastian Keinle had a terrible run, fading very hard in the end. And Lionel Sanders, even with that hitchy foot strike that he had, where he said he was dragging his right foot along the ground, he still kind of hung on. So I am just a complete junkie for data like this. Like I'm looking at lines on a screen and geeking out over understanding more about how the race went. And I was there. That was cool. All right, gang, I gotta go and run small errand. Relates to the drywall guy. All right, it is slippery and slidey out there. Just wait, here. I'll take you along. You'll see what Winnipeg is like in the winter. You all might not think it, being from not frozen parts of the world, but this was a beautiful ride. I like that a lot. A little sloppy, a little slushy, but nice, I'll take it. Insulated walls! So Traniacs, we got some insulated walls, everything. That wall,
that wall, that wall. We get a new garage door with a little bit more insulation, fitting a little bit tighter soon. All the windows are sealed, that main door sealed up. Yeah. I got my drywall guy coming here very shortly over the next week or so. He's gonna do the ceiling insulation, the baffles in the rafters. He's gonna do drywall on the ceiling. He's gonna do something very special for treatment on the walls. Oh, Triathlon Taren HQ. Oh, getting close, getting very close, gang. Later, Trainiacs. Hey, dogs.